What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about migrating a VMware Workstation VM into a ESXi server. So let's get right into that. So what's the reason for me migrating one of my VMware Workstation VMs to my hypervisor? The reason why is because I was testing out the vCenter within the workstation environment, and eventually everything was working okay, so I wanted to bring it over to the hypervisor, and this is the way that I did it. So within here, I clicked on File, and I located Export to OVF, so select that. I'm going to click on my Downloads folder, and I'm going to click on Save, and it's going to start exporting that particular virtual machine. Now, if you go inside the Downloads folder, it is going to give you a bunch of VMDK files as well as the OVF file. Now, within my hypervisor, because I have not turned it on as of yet, I'm going to click on Edit Virtual Machine Settings, and I'm going to bump up my 24 gigs to 38 gigs. It's up to you if you want to give it more. Okay, once you're done, click OK, power it on. Once it's powered on, open up your favorite browser and log into your hypervisor. Now, from here, I'm going to locate Create Register a VM, so select that. And out of the three options, I'm going to pick the second one, Deploy a Virtual Machine from an OVF or an OVA file. Right? Click Next here. Let's give it a new name. Pretty simple, right? And then click to select files or drag and drop here. So I'm just going to click it, go inside my Downloads folder, and I'm going to select all those files. Make sure you select all of them. It's not only the OVF file. You also got to select the VMDK file as well. So select them, open it, click Finish here. Select your new data store location, which is going to be this for me. Click Next. For the network, I'm going to switch it to my LAN. Click Next here. It's ready to go. And then click Finish. Once you click Finish, underneath the recent task, you're going to see that it is going to start importing, creating the virtual machine, and also importing all those VVMK files into your hypervisor. Now, if you go inside virtual machines, you're going to see your new server up and running. If you click on it and you go inside of it, you're going to see it's still processing. Now, the vCenter takes forever to load up, so just, you know, be patient, let it load up correctly. Now, once it's up and running, you're going to locate a workstation that is part of that network that the vCenter is in. So I'm going to open up Chrome and type in the full qualified domain of that server and hit enter. It's going to take me here. I'm going to log in with my credentials, and then bam, how awesome is that? That is how we migrate a VMware workstation VM into a hypervisor. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.